Frost PDP, and today we are playing Crusader Kings 2, When the World Stopped Making Sense. Alright, so let me get the mod stuff out of the way, because we are, as you can probably tell, playing on a mod. We are playing a When the World Stopped Making Sense. It's set in the Dark Ages, it's incredibly awesome, and I'm kind of just reading from my stream description here. You can judge whether or not that's worth it on your own. Welcome to what might be an interesting experiment. Today we're blah blah blah. I've always loved Roman history, okay? So like, that's a big thing, and as a teacher of history, in fact that's kind of why I haven't been on the channel much. I've been working, it's been like midterms and all that. It's kind of like, until the end of April, it's just going to be a slog. So anyway, I love Roman history, and I'm heavily inspired right now by the extra credits team and what they've done with extra history on Justinian and Suleiman. Suleiman is like the very first thing we taught this year. Well, okay, like the very second. And really cool. So I included a link to what they've been doing with Justinian in particular, and how they compare Justinian and Suleiman, especially since they lived in the same place pretty much. I've included links to the mod, and of course I've mentioned that this is a game by Paradox Studios, all rights reserved to them. Please do not sue me for using the term Let's Play, as I might once have been sued for the term React, because we all know that happened. So anyway, When the World Stopped Making Sense allows you to play from 476, fall the Western Roman Empire, to 1453, fall Eastern Roman Empire. I love the symmetry. There are three scenarios. For those who don't know, this is a live stream. It's being broadcast on YouTube, and I haven't really played around with this much. I did goof off in this one a little bit, but ultimately I find that it's a little bit too unfair from what I'm told. We're using all the Conclave stuff, by the way. I think that's the latest expansion. You know, the one with all the stuff to do with the Council, which I'd called for a long time from this game. So, oh yeah, since this is live, I might as well explain where I've been. I already did. I might as well explain why I haven't played CK2 in forever, which is, as you know, when I was playing Charlemagne, the game bugged out on me. Shattered Empire. Okay. 4 years ago, what a waster destroyed the Western Roman Empire. So this is like 4 years later. Okay. But now this is like after the fall of Rome. So I guess you can try to prevent the fall of Rome, or you can be Xenon and try to take it back, or Odoacer to keep it, or any of these other people that, honestly, like, who are you? The last of the governors, Sirius, also sought control. Okay. So kind of another guy, right? Like, so you're basically fighting over the remains of Rome. Cool. I'm not going to get too deep into the history of that, because I frankly don't know a lot of it. And again, Clovis, now he is fun. I've also watched, I might add a link to this later, Yale Courses Online has a free series on the early Middle Ages, which goes from about 250, believe it or not, in this professor's reckoning, to 1000 AD. And I keep wanting to say Paul Krugman, but it's Paul Friedemann who did the lectures. And he's really good, and he talks a lot about Clovis, and that's awesome, because, you know, he's the king of the Salian Franks, not to be confused with her Sicilians, succeeding his father Childeric in 481. Alright, so he basically becomes sort of a major player for a long time. He's the founder of the Merovingian dynasty, and guess what? They rule up until, wait for it, Charlemagne really comes into play, right? So, you know, descendant of Charles the Hammer and all of those good things, and able to overthrow the Merovingians, if I am not mistaken, which I could be, because it's been a while since I've actually read stuff. But none of these are Justinian. We have to go to custom game setup for that. So, we've got a few extra scenarios up here. You know, you've got what it says, and then you've got the extra ones. It's very much like, and I'm going to go into Realms mode just for the sake of ease. So, Western Roman Empire becomes Italy, which is ruled by Odoacer, which, of course, we know these guys don't. Although there's still some Western Rome. I'm completely ignorant to that fact, and interesting. Emperor Julius. I forgot about that, I guess. Eastern Rome. Alright, let's see. Shattered Empire. Frankish steel. But you notice something. It starts going kind of weird and almost like blank, right? The Gothic Wars. Basilius Justinian. Wait, huh? I want to see something. I thought for sure just like a child-sized Justinian, and I was like very confused. So the Gothic Wars. Basilius Justinian. Or he could be Theo, our dad. I'm never going to be able to say his first name. But I want to be Justinian. I'm older, though. I don't want to be older Justinian. Okay. So the Gothic Wars are set up. I think I see what they're doing. They're trying to best simulate the historical circumstances. Now, the problem I have with this map is, other than all, you know, a few token acknowledgments of outside, like, they have not filled this in. I believe they're going to tend to this all in a later release, and this is the only reason why I'm really apprehensive of playing as Justinian. See, it makes me want to go, like, go up to Little Augustus, where they have it all filled in, and they really do have most of the map filled in, and just, instead of being this dude, just be Justinian. I am now Justinian. Create a character, make him Justinian, and go. Because that's kind of almost what happened, but it's not. What a shame. So, the only real rule of dukes. Can I even be Justinian at this point? I can! How about here? No. Anastasios, the guy who came before Justinian. Damn. So I wonder if I can, like, play with the time thing. I wonder if it actually knows the dates. I know you guys have to be like, what? He's just playing around with the slider. So that's neat. 67. He's 67. Are you freaking... Oh, it's Justin. I'm sorry. I'm blind. They actually have their history correct. The places start disappearing. That's cool. Not too much for that trick, huh? So at least if we're going to do this, we're going to do this right. We are going to take over exactly when Justinian does. 46? Is that even correct? I'm not 100% sure off the top of my head, but this is... Oh, man. It's got nothing. I can't... Alright, I might as well change the title of this now. There's so much missing. You know what? This is part of why you explore a mod before you play it. There's just so... Okay, that's not missing. That's a dude. Alright. There's just so much missing. Sorry I'm being so quiet, I'm just thinking. So you start off at war with Italy, and that's bad. So I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do a create a character. Ethnicity Greek, party for pal, I don't care. Let's do this. I haven't done this in so freaking long. Married, yes. So that ages him by 2 years. That's stupid because I can just get married right off the bat. That's just strategically ill planned. I want another couple of points of health. Health doing that's not actually as pointless as it seems. My intrigue is somehow exceptional. Why? Amateurish plotter. Oh, education, right. Gotta make sure we get the good education. So, brilliant strategist. Comes with. I gotta add a couple of traits here. There are some things that should come for free. I want organizer. I guess I only get one free. Okay. Well, I really want organizer, I think, because that's going to be what? Movement speed and retreat. So, and that matters, especially with Shattered Retreat as a new mechanic, by the way. I do want to up that a bit. So other than being stupendously martial, do I need any traits? Can I go for wounded? I'll go wounded just because it's easy points. Quake will counter that almost. I'm sort of building for an old style of design, cruel. Do I want cruel? Nah, I want stuff that's gonna make it a little easier on me to manage vassals, at least on the start. Just because I'm not 100% sure what's gonna happen. And the game has changed quite a bit since I played. Calming voice, sure. That'll do it. I'm gonna name him Justiniish. Justiniish. Frost. Justinius Frost. He's wounded. He's quick. He's got a calm voice. Both inheritable traits. Very good. No sons, no daughters. He's old, so that's not so good, but he's in decent health. I can pick a thing that I like, a personality focus that I like. And I can't engage Iron Man because that would be stupid. Alright, we're going to finish. We're going to actually play. This is probably going to go to absolute crap because I'm probably not going to have any sort of proper familial claims, and there'll probably be someone who's got a lot of claims on me, but let's pretend, right? Maybe I'll end up just dead. So welcome to the beta. Things could go wrong. Okay. I have not played this since the latest patch. I have vassals. They probably don't like me too much. At least not all of them. I am unmarried. I should pick an ambition. Choose an ambition. Find a hobby? That's cool. That is... That's weird. I think that's just a botch of some sort. Convert a province. Okay, I remember that from somewhere. Find love? Huh. That's kind of cool. Okay. So I didn't know that was possible. So marriage is no longer an ambition. I'm bureaucratic. I have a non-dynastic heir, that makes sense. It's probably if it's supposed to be. Okay, what do I need? Hey, I can do a matrilineal marriage with three women. That makes no sense. So she has claims to the Western Roman Empire. So I want to marry her very badly. Yes. I don't care about anything else other than this one claim. I got a feeling I might need it. In fact, I could probably co-declare right now and just go. My domain is only 2 out of 18. That's bad. Like, really bad. Like, whoa. Why is there 65,000 men here? What the shit is this? I mean, I have a lot of men, but my god. Why is he marked as at war? What? Did I miss something? Oh, I'm defending in a war for the Empire against Xenon. Huh. That's bad. Okay. So he's invading him, and this guy's just got a bajillion event spawn troops. I should have been him. Okay. I have full Theodosian walls, so that's pretty significant. I certainly wish I had a better ally. Sassanids! Hey, guy. Can't make an alliance. I have to have a close round relative or a defensive pact. Huh? Nah, what? That makes no sense. Okay. I better think this through quickly, carefully. So you guys can just stand down, because you're not going to do any good anyway. Do we have boats to get them over? No. So these 2,000 men are basically dead to me. So these 2,000 men had better all go to the same damn place, which is here. I know I don't have the ranging guard, because that would be stupid. Mercenaries. I could raise some legions. Give me an extra 1,000 men. How much money do I make? Nothing, that's bad. So I can hire a few legions to try to smash him straight off the bat. Maybe I could pull some sort of divine conquer. Let me wait and see for a little bit what I can do. Probably should have done this before anything else. That was stupid, actually. I should still pick an ambition. Hobby might help. Training titles, council's discontent. Okay. Why? So you mean to tell me that the person who I put on my military council has a skill of a 9? First of all, I don't want him leading troops. Sorry. I feel as if I hear people talking. That's weird. I'm apparently picking up some conversation. That would be the Bluetooth. That's really weird. It's got a pace to it like it's a radio. What the heck? Have I gone mad? That is possible. Okay, let's ignore that. Let's just continue to play like nothing's wrong. Again, another thing I probably should have done. Have Mr. 9 military score. Do that. Who's my lowest happiness vassal right now? My spy master. Shouldn't he be not unhappy? He desires something I have. Do I have the thing to give? I do, but it's freaking mine. So he can just eat a dick. Go lead soldiers. Goodbye. Unless that sound is... I heard something about, like, if there's a discontent council, you'll hear sound or something. I don't know. I wish it would, like, tell me. I'm sorry I'm so quiet, I'm just reading. I'm not convinced it's really good music. It's because I have the council tab open. You hear people talking about the council tab? That's freaking mean. Alright. No air. Call in allies. I have allies? Yes, I will call them all in no matter how screwed they might think they are. Are you freaking kidding? Council is unhappy. I can't do much about that, unfortunately. Okay, my realm's a complete clusterfuck, I get it. Let's just go to speed 3 and play, because why not? We got nothing to lose. Let's see how these moves turn out. Okay, so you're in with your 746 Persians. Okay. If he marches them together, I'm screwed. You're in with your 5,000. That's better. You're in Meepa Meepa. I love the Meepa Meepas with 800. Okay. So I have something of a prayer. Maybe. Princess Lithia and Basilius Justiniish. Justiniish. I can get gold or I can get prestige. Well, assuming prestige still gives... happiness, that's 1.5 happiness right there. Vassal happiness, I should say. He's gonna walk around earning himself just like a bajillion attrition, right? But he's not gonna go for my capital or anything. I guess I don't really care too much. Old wound is gone. I'm now scarred, I get free prestige, and free points on character build. You're screwed if you go that way, so you're gonna go this way now. Try to form something that's gonna defend against one of his little box of troops. If he splits them too thinly, I have something I can do, otherwise it's just like, hope he attritions himself. Damn you, like 10% attrition every month? Good, die. I know I'm like overthinking this, but if I don't, I'm screwed. Huh? Favor on... What? The hell does that even mean? Okay. I can fire him. Could revoke his title. Kick his title away, I'm sure. Yeah, that would be bad. The High Patriarch? What? I'm a Miaphysite. Oh boy. Wait. I'm a Miaphysite in charge of the Empire. An Empire that is predominantly. What now? Niacin. Nicene, rather. Yeah, that's right. Jesus Christ, it's a long time ago. So I got a problem with that, I think. God, I hate this dude. So you're the despot of Achaea, right? So I need to go to Achaea. That's your capital. I need to drop you right in here so that you'll break this bullshit up. I need you. You're an independence faction member, but you know what? You're not gonna fuck with me too much while we're at war, right? So these guys look like they're heading south. They're slowly breaking up. If we all join together in the middle, we might have a chance. Sweet dog. Faithful, because we're a good guy. Huh? So restore the Roman Empire, reunite the two Roman Empires. You have to have 3,000 prestige and be emperor both. That ain't so bad. Organize exhibitors. Get an organization. Get an organization. Okay. How much money are we making per turn? Whoa, 131! What did they do to the economy of this game? Yes! The monthly cost is significant, but the cash cost, not so much. Grouped. This one had about 7,000 men. Meanwhile, he's chasing my dudes down here like an idiot. Good. He's splitting. No, he's not. He's confused. Not sure what to do. Okay, but we're not going to do increased council power. Am I hiding in favorable terrain here? Hebrew, wow. Who'd have thunk? Plains, no, not really. Defensive packs. How did you look at the terrain again? Okay, this does not help. I gotta be honest, this is not helping me here. Show me where the freaking mountains are. Mountains. Hi-Rez, we need to get there. Before I even worry about anything else, we need to get there. It absolutely needs to be attached to the screen, which I can't do. Okay. So I have a few ideas. I could go a little bit batshit and start trying to raise a huge army to just crush him. If I start raising some of these legions, it's 1,000 men a pop. I can't really get high enough to do it. It's only enough to defend against a straight crossing, really. And even that's questionable. Starting to siege down some territory now. No, he's not. He's gonna wander around in the desert some more. Maybe he's seen my army and he thinks he has a chance against it. But there are 5,000 men that are going to storm his ass in a minute. As long as he keeps walking around in a circle, there's no problem. Thank you. Good job. GG, good going. Siege. Whoa! That was fast. Oh, okay. Siege this. Still kind of fast, though. But he's splitting these guys up more. Sneaking them around is stupendously complicated. 7 plus a few thousand, it's still just not enough. It's coming for us. You know what? I've got so much money coming in, I might as well. What am I gonna lose? The Empire? I mean, I'm already down 13%. That's a big freaking group. Alright. See what I can do. He might take me in the south, but it's gonna cost him. Group in the Commedia. Let's see if I can win one or two. Desert. I don't know what to make of this. I mean, if I had this army up here, I'd freaking just straight up engage him. Gotta just play it out a little more slowly. He's coming in to battle in Tyrus. So I need to make sure my best guy's fighting. Besides me, because I don't want to die. Justin is actually the Justin who is the emperor, by the way. The future emperor. I wish I could just nominate successor. It'd be so cool if he kills the player and you get to play as Justin and then have Justinian as your heir. That'd be awesome. Alright, so Constance. I need the percentage wrong guy. I need the percentage modifiers here. Okay, so this is where it gets complicated, game. You need to know that you guys need to take this battle. I have no way of telling this army to come join us, do I? Because at 10,000, we can actually do some what good there. It's alright, I'm gonna get this giant stack across the ocean myself. Haha, forgot that I had that, didn't you? I also have Gobert in charge. Alright, guys. July 2nd. He's not coming to reinforce, is he? He's not. You bastard. He's only at one flank. And I have a flanker. This actually could backfire on him significantly. I mean, that's not bad. Our center flank is going to take just horrendous losses. I probably should have stacked the center a little better, but... We actually held our own quite well there. So he's gonna path all the way back up to where exactly where I want him. Good. Flanker, you're with me. Dude who's got 18. Do you have a Varangian? No, guard veteran. I mean, it's the same difference, but... So all my top military dudes with me. Ruler present. Bravely risking my own life. No shit. Oh, he has to know that, does he? If I can get... here, maybe... I have to like break this down into like micro moves, because as long as his troops don't... Are you... really? Would you? Ha, he wouldn't. I know, we're gonna have some suffering here. I wish the units got locked into movement. He's next to his own buddy. all mountainous. That's a problem. So basically I have to ask myself how much damage I can do before. Or I could just sink my prestige and create more units. Well, I don't want to spend too much money on too many dudes, but a couple of companies wouldn't be so bad. They're more expensive. Heavy caviar in it really wouldn't hurt. It's way too pricey. Trying to keep this war at a containable cost. And again, that's some pretty bitchin' amounts of power. Oh, you bastards. I just clicked the wrong button. I can't believe I did that. It'll bait them into tagging, at least. Did. Here we go. Completely screwed that up. But I have to hold the mountains, otherwise I'm deeply screwed. Can't believe I did that. It's only got one flank, I've got three, same as before. Interesting. We are holding. Sort of, kind of. I'm actually holding. Flanks. I'm gonna lose, but I really hurt him. Order a retreat! Rome has fallen. What a shock. What? I lose 1,000 piety and prestige? That is some bullshit. Non-dynastic air much? That's really bad. So he has 20,000 left. That's not an unsurmountable amount. I made a huge blunder. That's my problem. It's my sole problem right now. Troop inflation at this moment isn't a particularly advantageous option, but I make 58 bucks a month. It would cost 27. Huamar Haptita. Yeah, sure, you're cheap. Keep that count a little higher. Oh crap, I'm in trouble. See, now if y'all stick together, maybe we have a chance here. Because I can maybe catch this group with their pants down and start winning battles. Go, now. I'm so tempted to engage him just to stall him. Idiots got caught out. But you managed to secure it in the mountains. Okay, good. This is what I want to see. We reinforced. We have this force field going on. I don't know what that means. Flank leaders manage to find a favorable spot, make the flank narrow, and in the full force, the enemy can't charge at them. So what's that mean? Am I winning or losing? I can't tell. But right now, he's in a really bad engagement. They're in total rout. They really joined in. They immediately got squashed. Alright, now we're on to something here. If his next group joins in, they're in... Are you freaking kidding? Oh, man. Okay, can I find out how that would have gone? I mean, really? Oh man, that sucks so bad. To die like that, I really should have invested in a son, huh? Thought getting married would address that situation, but apparently not. Yeah, that's about the appropriate picture. Well, that was fun. Let's try that autosave one more time. If there's even anything to autosave from. So at this point, we're just reduced to save scum because we died, right? I mean, that's terrible. That's just terrible. How bad is it? We have our 14,000 men shattering south. Probably my dude doing like religion or something. Basically getting to replay the battle. That's kind of cool. I don't know if I really want to, but let's pretend I do. You might not even want to make that engagement this time. capital's in the mountains. Let's go straight to the mountains then. Right? No? You don't want to do that, guy? I wonder if... he thinks I'm heading for the capital. So we have 14, I assume. What if we reunite a Galatia? And the worst happens, we get caught in the mountains defending anyway, right? Why? Plot leader. Does he have any money? No, he's not really worth a... what's his plot? Oh, yeah, no, I want him dead. Good, great. February 27th of February. Danced away. Now it's time to not screw this part up again. Just got some big money. Let's try a couple more big guns. Gonna beat my allies here because they were stupid and didn't run, but that's a nice diversion because now I can get together some mess. He'll suffer casualties, right? I mean, some. Plan that a little better. So that's desert, so I don't want to die there. Got a river crossing too. Definitely have to go for it. Could use that prestige right about now. Okay. I honestly provide nothing. That guy on a flank. Give another flanker at 14. Arbitrary is bad. Cruel the morale damage would actually be really advantageous. It's 2-1. I mean, it's bad. It's gonna be 2-1 at least until I get this guy, and it's still gonna be a significant disadvantage. At least I'm not gonna die in combat this time. Council can suck a dick. Mountains, mild winter, and there is a river crossing between these two provinces. So basically he's charging in against everything imaginable. He takes the fight anyway, which is expected. He's probably gonna win, but maybe not. Thank you. Come on, get there, get there, get there, get there, get there. Shit. Sweet, total annihilation. That might be enough war score to end the war. It's close. And only 4,000 men survived. So, there's that. That happened. This is now realm size 443. Interesting. Total number of holdings. It's new. So, it's capital time, huh? I want my wife to like me. I don't care about any of these things as long as she will produce me a child. How about that? You do that and I'm a happy guy. They are legit pathing the same path. We're all gonna end up in the same place, so. Really, as soon as I can afford to hire a group, I better hire a group. Not a crappy group. They're identical. I can wait a little while. Okay. He's gonna cross. I mean, it's plains, but it's a straight crossing. I mean, it's gotta be something. Borrow money from the Jews? Sure thing! Choose a patron saint. The Blessed Virgin Mary. Gold? Damn, I need it right about now. I have 510. I can hire 300 group. have this. I have 200 left. I have the monthly budget to cover this, right? So I'll hire you. And then I'll hire you. And you're gonna stand. And we're gonna win this. Because we have Constance. Theus. I also got a combat skill. Justin. I need it. Alrighty, guys. Time to party, huh? Straight cross. 20%. So he's fighting as if he's got 8,000 less troops about. Okay. We have a couple extra dudes trickling in as time goes on. We're definitely enduring the heavier losses. This is not good. Better. Much better. Still losing per capita, but did he lose 1,000 in a day? I believe we just won. Okay, so that swings the war score a little bit. I really thought I was going to lose that. Okay. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. We lost 4. He actually lost a lot more than we did, and our numbers, our overall grand scheme numbers are now even. Okay. He's in Shattered Retreat. I don't know where to. Yes, you want to kick me out, I get that. In the meantime, let me do my job. Just to win this war, by the way. Don't think he's going that way, but who knows. Can I recover troops? He doesn't. I think the game just sort of went weird because my OBS thing popped up. Apparently this thing's telling me the stream is complete, now it's resuming, so if you're experiencing technical difficulties, I have no say over that, I'm sorry. It's just, there's issues going on, I guess. Oof, that's bad. Just in case I forget, but fifth. They're not getting away anyway. Thank you. Okay, guys, don't be stupid. Good for you. You dumbasses are not seriously doing what I think you're doing. I know he's trying to get away from being attrition to death, but he's actually walking his friends with death trap. 29th. He arrives 6th Jan. Okay. You're flanking, you're defending, you're doing your thing. And just hold ground. I don't think there's any more reinforcements I can give. Should, can I be building right new? I mean... I could create like 500 men. Get a couple of light infantry and send them in to die, but that's rather pointless. I need combat capable troops now. So we'll see. Alright, I have the larger troop count. He is crossing a river. That's pretty good. I have better command. Well, hold on. What the hell are you? Yikes. So what you mean to tell me is they have a Super Saiyan. That is a Super Saiyan, okay? No other way to explain him. But they don't have a commander on their other side. Too bad that's the side that Justin's on, so we can't maximize the advantage there, but Super Saiyan, okay? Just let me deal with that process for a minute. We have our ally coming in to help us, which will keep us a little bit ahead. We're actually doing a pretty good job on our... We broke one of them. Broke two of them. Super Saiyan is holding, but taking heavy losses. We broke three of them shortly. The fuck are you? Oh, you're getting dealt with. Time to actually siege him up. Wanna, like, get you pregnant or something? Like, can I switch focus? Now I can actually push an attack on him. Especially if he goes to his capital to recoup. Story in the book. Peasant revolt. Tortosa. Where even the hell is that? Who cares? So insignificant. Alright, that happened. Fact. Clicky. Clicky the button. It's with the blues. Give me the blues, brother. How bad is the supply situation? Pretty bad. Alas. Wait, get off your capital. That's a great idea. Really, really great idea. You do that. Be happy to sit here on the coast and just snuff you out, man. Oh, thank God. This guy's gonna be a little less annoyed. Hey, if I killed him... If I could kill him, I'd inherit his land. Should be nice. Can I copulate already? I'm known as the Wicked. Why? What the hell did I do? Alright, suck off then. Tell anyone who has siege speed. This list is ridiculous, by the way. Just paradox, ridiculous list. Yeah, I want him as my guy, actually. I'm gonna send this 10 guy. Can I maybe find a siege leader? No. Disappointing. It's all about to fight those rebels. It's gonna take a while. He's gonna recap that, but as soon as I have his capital, he's in danger. Start thinking of ways to survive this. I have lots of money. I actually make a lot more money than I would have thought I would. I'll build a shipyard real quick, because I have the money. I have the funds and I feel like I'm safe. I almost want to build another castle. In fact, I might. So it looks like this mod allows for a lot more money, but it also allows for a lot more accurate money, I guess you could call it. Vendel. Who are you losing a war against? You're attacking Autoacer, you lunatic! Never mind, apparently you're gonna win. Sweet, I'm a poet. Does that get me in bed with my wife? Really need a kid here. I guess I won the peasant revolt. Debutante is that much? Keeps changing the name. That's neat. It's okay. That. I want to end this war as fast as I can. Are you besieging? You are! Awesome! I owe you guys. I still have a house. don't care what you create. Create themes all you want. Go for it. Enjoy. Huh? This dude died. So you're very powerful now. Angry for not being on the council. I don't have a chancellor, apparently. I meant to hit the space bar, by the way. My own damn fault, in a sense. What's going on? Okay, nothing important. What are your actual scores? You're actually not so bad at being chancellor. So... refuse to serve or some shit? Alright, become a counselor. Enjoy. So I have an opinion map mode, right? Did not expect this to be labeled bureaucratic as opposed to feudal anymore. It's kind of cool. Should reward that guy. Opinion. So you don't like me very much, you really don't like me. Alright. Get to making him feel better. Wait, what? He declared independence. Huh? That's weird. Like, the kind of weird that I wonder how he did that. Not like the legions or anything, right? I don't remember they're supposed to like go rogue or some shit. Again, part of this is born of just a lack of understanding of this mod and what it takes. Okay, I have 100% and more. I don't get anything for that, of course. So. I could execute him. Money's not worth it. You won't vassalize. Plot to kill would be pointless. Alright, whatever. Goodbye. Let me get my men back to my own lands here and see what the fuck I'm dealing with. Now is when you start building retinue, by the way. So, good use of a favor there, I suppose. Get my guys back on my soil. If it really should be like... I can start considering some things. As many troops, and this I can pull entire circles out of them. That would be pretty suitable, I think. Let's start with that. Down. How bad is it gonna be? Some might just say, yep. That's really annoying. It's not even a real threat. I mean, like, I put like 20 bucks down and already I've got a larger army than you do. Who left? Whatever, just make the highest ranking dude a dude. Same thing here. Do I have any vassals to expect from the council? No? Alright. Highest ranking dude, I'm not gonna use the dude. Patriarch went independent. You've got to be joking. I have to besiege him. That gives him time to gather a significantly greater number of troops than I'm capable of handling. Beat the first army off the bat, there's not a problem. Morale sucks, but whatever, we'll make it. It's better than his. I'll say that. Flank. Charge. useful. There's only gotta be one flank, too. He's not even moving them. So they're dead on the spot. Only a few before they shatter, but that's okay. Actually, their advantage in morale lets them stay longer and die longer. Early winds in here. Space to play hide in the mountains again. Oh, aren't you cute? Freaking idiots. Twenty-eighth, they're dead. You may go through now. Reinforce? He's gonna have 7,000 men. I'm gonna pump up to more than that very soon. In fact, solely to ward off the threat of another group. Let's pick you guys up. And you guys too. That ought to quiet down the threat of independence faction just a little bit. Unless you'd be going at it alone, you'd lose. Castle Shipyard has been built. Excellent. Can't really afford to build anything else right now, so... And that's ours. So already, I've beaten you. Thank you. Revoke title, Kingdom of Thrace. Maybe you'll just stay in my prison for a while, hmm? Army levies can stand down. Now can I declare a war? I can. How many troops does this bastard have? Okay. Somehow you managed to walk away with a lot of Imperial land. I haven't figured that out. That's not my problem. Right now what I know is you need to die. Why am I suddenly in tremendous debt? Inherited something, yay! What did I inherit? I inherited this. Doll capital? Yes, it is! Alright. Good, I've become stronger. Through other people dying. Alright, whatever. The debt doesn't matter. It's like the United States military. It doesn't matter. Just kill them all. and he won't be able to raise up a huge army. So this mod is definitely different, I have to say. I've been playing now for quite a while. It's been enjoyable. I don't like how this guy sort of broke away without really anything. Like, he just took a bunch of land all of a sudden. Okay, you are in the mountains. Everyone's got defender. That doesn't help me. I really need someone stronger than you. I know he's in the mountains. I know this is a tough battle to win. And I have a river cross. This may be suicide. I definitely like how mountains have much more of an effect now. One. I'm not sure where he's going. War score seems to make a lot more sense these days. Shadow retreat doesn't. It seems like he can retreat whichever direction he freaking wants. Got his mountains bonus, but he doesn't have enough to stop me. The money never hurts. Chase them down! Kick their butts. 6th, 31st, he's toast. Again. So, I'm not liking this in the sense that, like, I'm ping-ponging them across a very long distance. Okay. on. I think I'll just hold on to you for a bit. Will you surrender? No. So the Western Empire won yet? It did, okay. Neat little straight there. Convenient. Temperance, very fun. I hear that two of my guys are fighting. So who's the other guy you're at war with? Civil war for a monarchy. Well, look at you guys, ain't you cute? So I'm basically kicking his army across his own country time and time again for nothing. Because it's not like I'm destroying it or I'm getting a max war score or anything. Meanwhile, he raises up a bajillion men out of nowhere. And now I'm dying. I am 51. Now I know... That's nice. Well, you're sort of a weirdo. Even Hellenic. Yeah, I could arrest you. And you do hate me. Why do you hate me? Why am I a tyrant? Better not do this while I'm in the middle of a war. Just saying. Really, at 98%. So many other problems. So little time. Should probably be developing my city now that I mention it. Yep. And here where I am king, I should build a new castle. Why? Because that's probably the shortest way to get a new levy. And military. Retinue. It does cost me a bunch, but... I'm actually at my cap. Neat. Laws, technology. Not getting that much tech, but not that little. Military org would be nice. Supply limit and morale is awesome. Not quite there yet. Noble customs would help greatly. How did I not get more war score for that? Was I not somehow the primary victor here? Threatening. Really? You think? So I get 6% off per year. It's like you jerk-offs pretty much made me. On me. Let me boost that up. But now I have 9 holdings, right? That's not bad. It's all under the new recently conquered shit. That expires in a year. And then I just go drop down to 3070. So that's not so bad. That's a significant chunk of land. Aren't you a traitor? Sure, get out. I am merciful, don't ever forget it. I have like tons of light infantry in my retinue, it's really pathetic. I could kill his raiders for him, but I won't. I'm ill again. No, you know what? I'm sunside above at some time, isn't it? It's rather hot outside. You've been out a bit too long doing whatever business we're doing, you should feel lightheaded. I'm ill. Hey, I still don't have an heir. What the hell? You know what to do. Character search. Search realm for women. My religion, my culture, more likely to be good. Married, doesn't matter. Adult, of course. Look for lustful. There's one. Seduce. She's not the best out there. But let's put it this way. Oh, a scan? Really? A scan? Yeah, no. Yeah, okay. Everyone and their mother has joined. Christ! Dude, you're all the way down in freaking Africa! Oh shit. They can refuse seduction? Wow. You know what that means? Okay, this is too low. Damn it! I can't afford the debutante. A couple months I can, but I'll be dead by then. I can't try to seduce her. She's just not getting pregnant. Rejecting seduction attempts. Oh, Christ. My wife won't get with me. Well, let's go back to the character finder. Peasant revolt, how sweet. What was I gonna do? That's right, I was gonna revoke all your titles. You are a traitor. Actually have a theme. The theme of Europa, which is this. De jure, it should contain Calipolis, but Calipolis is King Theodoric of the Calician Goths. That makes sense. He controls. Tribe of Thracian Goths. Controls Thrace. Weird. My men have to fight this stupid vault, so do yours. Let's move to Moesia's forest. Soldier named Justin. Whoa, hey, whoa, this is it. A lack of a proper realm heir has proven unsettling to some of the nobles of the realm. Luckily, a young man named Justin from a village. Hey, guess what? I have an heir. Okay, legendary leader it is. Well, I was worried about not playing as Justinian. It appears I'm going to get to, and I'm get to have the full map. Because now, I have an heir of my dynasty. My son. His parents are only mine. Well, there you go. See, game? That wasn't so hard, was it? Munda Shaliki. What? Oh. Well, then I don't need you to exist. So just because I have one son does not mean I don't want two or three. Well, hold on here. What am I doing? First off. We're not supposed to be sieging this down, or is this just a peasant revolt? I guess the peasants have to get there. I'm not really sure. I inherited the kingdom of Egypt! Alright. You're powerful and you want to be on the council. I hate you. But here you go. Yeah, I could kill him if I wanted, probably. Yeah. Maybe not. Okay, now I'm starting to think I may have a problem. I can't even begin to see through all this. Egypt. Who's in Egypt is actually worth first of all this? Oh, they're retinue. Well then, keep. Work your way up north, guys. You hate me. That's nice. You would not hate me if I gave you what you wanted. Grace, Royalty of Thrace. I go all the themes that I have that are too many. And now you only hate me by 70. Why? Too many held duchies. Okay, I can fix that a little bit. But in the meantime... I'm not making my spy master if you hate me. Why do I hold too many duchies for this guy? You know what? He is entitled to this thing of Alexandria. Or I can give it to someone I like. Men. Not in prison. My religion, my culture. Adult, yes. Great house, no. Look at military score. The grant him Alexandria. And now I can grant him the Viceroyalty over the theme of Alexandria. And he hates me. But that's because I have too many duchies, and I have to solve this problem. Okay. What's another duchy I have that I don't really particularly want? Dimatia. Well, if it's titular and no one's fucking using it, why do I have it? Yeah, good, go. You have that. So I could buy a favor from him, but he wouldn't let me. I am a third, and he hates me. Why do you hate me? Because you won control of the Empire, and you're a dick. Sending you money would not really help. I actually own this land, I don't want to get rid of it. Should destroy the damn title? No. Succession is not Gavelkind. I'm pretty sure my succession is not Gavelkind. Yeah, so I don't know what the deal with that is. He's gotta be pissed at me because he's gotta wanna get a hold of... He doesn't want it. Pro DP. But I own it. Huh. Yeah. destroy this title? I can. Don't need it, don't want it, get rid of it. Kingdom of Thrace, Eastern Empire, Scythian Minor. None of us own this. You gotta be kidding me. Can't afford to lose 200 prestige. This, I don't mind giving up to somebody. Let me see something real fast. 30 vassals, governments, trade zones. I'm very curious about something. Who are you? You are Lustful Content, Helenothracian. Who are you? Much worse. What if I instead grant you Constantia? Then I grant you Scythian Minor. Now I have a vassal republic to bring in even more money than I needed. Ha ha, yes. And that actually all but solves my too many theme problem. I need a few of them. Rodopi and Yid. Sorry, I can't destroy it right now. I may later. So I should give him land. It says Gavelkind, but that can't be. Agnatic Hygienic Progenitor. Right? Right, yeah, there you go. Got another few hundred retinue coming up. It's the Kingdom of Thrace, which is mine. I enjoy it being mine, actually. Can't afford a castle. Damn, what a shame. That'll change in a couple of days. Might have been Heracle in the hopes of seducing this chick, but she ran away. I still don't have a natural born son, though. That's kind of painful. Oh, right, castle. I should probably do something about that, huh? So you are powerful, you like me a lot, and you are a 15 spymaster. You're also ill as hell! Good. Same way the world, I could study tech that'd be worthwhile. No, that's what I thought. This dude's talking fucks to me so bad. You know, add a check's not too fast. Damn it, that's Gavelkind. The Kingdom of Thrace is Gavelkind. I can destroy the title, however. That's weird. Ride me. That's what she's saying. What's my threat level? I'm threatening 47. Declare war. Why can't I declare war? I should not have any raised army levies. What levies do I have raised? Apparently a lot. So if I were to declare on you... Yeah, that's not good. Huh. Freaking world unites against me. Well, we certainly have some issues, don't we? Prestige of at least 500. That's all I can do here. The problem is, Justinian wouldn't be trying to redeem the Western Empire. He runs the Empire. As he dies, his son is the heir. That's a problem. Can make him a tributary realm. That'd be interesting. But she said, bribe me, damn it. Women. Women, I tell you. So, basically, I'm coalitioned. I don't have a clue what this means. Now it begins to flood once more. Egyptian will sigh with relief. Okay. The Pope apparently exists. The Papal States. He belongs to Italy. He belongs to Augustus. I'm assuming even a war against the Ostrogoths would get me in a lot of trouble, wouldn't it? The Empire would prevent me from reconquering the Empire. So I reconquered part of my land that went independent, and now I'm locked on coalition mode for, like, ever, right? Granting independence, not part of my de jure realm. Why would I do that? This has basically become useless, actually. Because my character is so threatening that... Yeah. So, this is what I was afraid of when I heard Conclave was introducing threat systems. I thought, wait a minute. I'm just gonna end up with a long branch of time where I can't do anything. So in the process of reconquering my damned empire, the parts that just went independent for no reason, all of a sudden, I can't even do that. Quickly. I can't just be like, hey, guy, Let me beat you up, because I have to beat everyone on Earth up. And he will never vassalize because of false religion. Never mind that he hates me. He has an heir. No, he has a non-dynastic heir. I could theoretically try to assassinate him. I mean, 51 is really not doable, but maybe through bribery. Nope, they all hate me. Just go screw their realm up. I want to see if this does anything. Now, why am I getting money? Actually, over the retinue limit. Yeah, I'm ambitious. How much debt does this dude have? He took over the entire empire. Oh look, more peasant rebels. What a threat. Personally, I think that should have paused it. The 10 men I'm getting out of most of these places is not impressive. Now, I hit control when I did that, so he must have moved on that guy pretty quick. That's frustrating. Gonna run them away as fast as I can. They'll probably shatter to like Mars, but cool, right? Huh? Oriental revolt. My vassals let a revolt on my vassal. Huh? That was stupid of you. That mean I have a chance to... Levy's raised, of course, but if I could I declare war? I don't like that. I don't find any fun in that. Thank you. Are you freaking kidding me? You just targeted the retinue that I had that was over the limit, so now I can't rebuild it. My fault for not double checking, but that's really annoying. It didn't cost me anything to make, at least. So basically, it just doesn't do what it used to do and get rid of all of them, just gets rid of some of them. Out of an abundance of curiosity, let's pretend I wanted to declare war on you. You're telling me the Western Roman Empire would stop me. Make this a tributary. Axum actually rivals me as an empire. No CB though. Conquer one province from the Sassanids and not have too much of a problem. Or just make them all tributary. What military does this jack-off have? 9,000? You know, he has revolts on. We could do it. Assassinate my tributaries? That could be interesting. So, yeah. I mean, I hate to sound like I'm disappointed, but I'm a little disappointed in that I am so locked in by my... And I was afraid of this, and I was a vocal concernist on Reddit and everything about this. Threat really is too limiting. Like, look, I'm not saying let it be so I can snowball and expand, but, you know, make it like cultural unions first to oppose somebody, like, most common ground, cultural and religion together, and then one separately, and like, these guys should be my freaking allies. Instead, they hate me. But what, I can't understand what his threat would be, because... fighting a liberation revolt. I don't know how to make a non-aggression pact with a guy. Look, just if you're gonna make this game into EU4 paradox, please make it into EU4 correctly. Right now, this is kind of a mess. I'm not saying that because I don't like it. I love Crusader Kings. I'm saying it because this makes no sense. Like, you know, if a high threat person declares on a high threat person, that should do something. If a guy's reclaiming land he has claims to, like, come on, it's Imperial Reconquest. And... I did Imperial Reconquest, and now I'm basically threat-locked forever. Because I got 50% for some reason. Pagan defense, Christian defense, and Mazdan defense. So basically find someone who's a Mazdan religion and claim on them? Like, is that what I really have to do here? Cartelian. So if I could declare war on him, for any good reason... She's not even, like, already... paying the Sassanids. So I'm guessing war with him would be a war with Sassanids. That's an infinite loop. Eastern Roman Empire. Did I miss something? Why are you labeled Eastern Roman Empire? you're married to someone who is in the Eastern Roman Empire. That was a weak claim. You consider yourself a king, so you'd never vassalize under me anyway. Hate me and false religion. Out of curiosity, can I proselytize in foreign lands? Of course not! Not in other sort of pseudo-Christian lands, anyway. That's painful. I will get crushed if I do that. So this is where I'm gonna leave it, because I think I'm tired of playing this game for a while. It's been fun. I've overall had an interesting time playing out the experiment, and I love that it built in Justinian, just as it kind of happened in history. I mean, okay, in a slightly different way, because his father is technically the Justin guy I have running around as my second in command, and the emperor himself, you know, you get the deal, right? So, I don't know. There's a lot of things I don't know. I'm not, like, the biggest fan of all of this. Like, I don't like Threat at all. I think Threat is way overpowered. I was really concerned about this, and it's why I didn't pick the game up more recently. I love the mod. Definitely love the mod. It works. It could be better. There are a few things that are wonky with it. I think it really starts you off with, if not unfair situations. I'm gonna let time run while I talk. If not unfair situations, where you're facing 60,000 men, and you've got to recruit men off. I mean, I guess now I see that I could have probably done it as Augustulus. What now? Alaric, huh? Oh, I remember you. You exist. Can I declare war now, maybe? Like, free my guy? No. How about war crimes? How about threat level? No, that didn't even touch the threat. That's really, well, 23. Damn. You know what your job is? Research cultural tech. Yep. So I don't know what other scripted events there would be other than maybe a Theodora one. I'm not sure how all of these legion people end up getting to be heirs to land. That sort of makes no sense. My domain is now too big. And so here's the thing, if it was for a claim on the entire empire, I would do it in a heartbeat. I wouldn't even hesitate. I would declare, and I'd be in. Because, you know, claims, right? Like, they're kind of important. I hope Italia is not a higher title than the Roman Empire, by the way. I don't know. I'm not sure. But anyway, I'm going to take a break here. Hit the like and subscribe buttons. As I mentioned earlier in the stream, you know, life is a thing that happens to me. So I don't always get to post or play. But, you know, I play a lot of Planet Side 2 because that's easy to hop in and play. and I'm pretty decent at it. You can look through that stuff. My Charlemagne campaign and my Critical Castile campaign, I would strongly recommend you check them out. If you got time. If you don't, you know, whatever. Maybe I'll make a shorter video about, like, my thoughts on Conclave so far. But generally speaking, like, I feel like there needs to be some way to at least reduce threat directly. Like, apply effort to reduce threat. Like, improve religious relations or something that this guy could do to reduce threat. Because if he's not, what's the point, right? I mean, if it had something to do with state diplomacy, that could work too, you know? Oh, combined, I've got a diplomacy of 28. What does that give me? What does that let me do? How does that affect my threat? You know, that should be clearer. And monthly decay is even going down. Just for one conquest, it's 50%. And if I die, apparently that carries over. And it's not like I can attack, I can ask vassals to declare war, can I? And it's religious conversion, I can. Why not? The myth is I faith ascendant. He says no because he doesn't like me. He doesn't like me a lot. He wants to be on the council. Why isn't he on the council? Because he sucks. I could grant him... I could send him money, but that won't do it. I can grant him independence, but I don't want to. You like me. I can send you $300 and you'll go for 14. That's useless. Let's see... Demand religious conversion. No. Get a lot of that these days. Still no, huh, pal? Didn't I let you out of jail? So, they need to either like me a lot or be very threatened by me to convert. You in jail? I have you in jail. Alright, what do you want? You are a douchebag, huh? Tyrant and Merciful are offsetting. Wasn't that nice? Still won't do it, huh? There should be like a convertible button. Like, anyone who would want to convert will convert if you click this button. But at least there's some differences. So I've done some stuff. I don't know. If you want to see me play some of this more, hit the like and subscribe buttons. If there's something else you'd like me to try, Master of Orion 3 looks really good, but I don't have the money for it, unfortunately. Dead honest. I know I'm like big shot teacher guy now, but I honestly don't have the money because, you know, loans are expensive. I can't even really say I could afford a U4 to update that and to get into that. Even though that looks more interesting at this point. Play Master Roaring 2. That could be interesting. I could try Kerbal Space Program and blow myself up repeatedly because I'm very terrible at that game. So, leave me a like, leave me a comment, hit the buttons, you know the drill. Thank you for joining me, and as always, with my videos, La Paz.